Yehoshua chapter 6. And Jericho was shut up tight because of the presence of the sons of Israel, not going out and not coming in. And Yahweh said to Yehoshua, See, I have given Jericho and its sovereign, mighty brave men, into your hand. And you shall go around the city, all the men of battle, go around the city once. Do this for 6 days, and let 7 priests bear 7 shofarot of the Yovelim before the ark. And on the 7th day go around the city 7 times while the priests blow with the shofarot. And it shall be, when they make a long blast with the horn of a Yovel, and when you hear the voice of the shofar, that all the people shout with a great sound, and the wall of this city shall fall down flat, and the people shall go up every man straight before him. And Yehoshua son of Nun called the priests and said to them, Take up the ark of the covenant, and let 7 priests bear 7 shofarot of Yovelim before the ark of Yahweh. And he said to the people, Pass over and go around the city, and let him who is armed pass over before the ark of Yahweh. And it came to be, when Yehoshua had spoken to the people, that the 7 priests bearing the 7 shofarot of the Yovelim before Yahweh passed over and blew with the shofarot, and the ark of the covenant of Yahweh went after them. And the armed men went before the priests who blew the shofarot, and the rear guard came after the ark, going on and blowing with the shofarot. But Yehoshua had commanded the people, saying, Do not make a sound or cause your voice to be heard, nor let any word come out of your mouth until the day I say to you, Shout! Then you shall shout. And the ark of Yahweh went around the city, going around once, and they came into the camp and stayed in the camp. And Yehoshua rose early in the morning, and the priests took up the ark of Yahweh, and 7 priests bearing 7 shofarot of the Yovelim before the ark of Yahweh were walking, going on, and they blew with the shofarot, and the armed men went before them. But the rear guard came after the ark of Yahweh, going on and blowing with the shofarot. And the 2nd day they went around the city once, and returned to the camp. Thus they did 6 days. And it came to be on the 7th day that they rose early, about the dawning of the day, and went around the city 7 times in this way. Only on that day they went around the city 7 times. And it came to be at the 7th time, when the priests blew with the shofarot, that Yehoshua said to the people, Shout, for Yahweh has given you the city. And the city shall be put under the ban, it and all that is in it belongs to Yahweh. Only Rahab the whore is to live, she and all who are with her in the house, because she hid the messengers that we sent. And you, by all means guard yourselves from that which is under the ban, lest you come under the ban when you take of that which is under the ban. And make the camp of Israel a curse, and shall trouble it. But all the silver and gold and vessels of bronze and iron are set apart to Yahweh, they go into the treasury of Yahweh. And the people shouted when the priests blew the shofarot, and it came to be when the people heard the voice of the shofar, and the people shouted with a great shout, that the wall fell down flat. And the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they captured the city. And they put under the ban all that was in the city, both man and woman, young and old, and ox and sheep and donkey, with the edge of the sword. And to the 2 men who had spied out the land, Yehoshua said, Go into the house of the woman, the whore, and from there bring out the woman and all that she has, as you swore to her. And the young men, the spies, went in and brought out Rahab, and her father, and her mother, and her brothers, and all that she had. So they brought out all her relatives, and set them outside the camp of Israel. And they burned the city and all that was in it with fire. Only the silver and gold and the vessels of bronze and of iron they put into the treasury of the house of Yahweh. However, Yehoshua kept alive Rahab the whore, and her father's household, and all that she had. And she dwelt in the midst of Israel to this day, because she hid the messengers whom Yehoshua sent to spy out Jericho. And Yehoshua warned them at that time, saying, Cursed is the man before Yahweh who rises up and builds this city Jericho. He lays its foundation with his firstborn, and with his youngest he sets up its gates. And Yahweh was with Yehoshua, and a report about him was in all the land.